Hey, what's going on, guys? So I've removed ahead real quick because I only had a friend here for a minute and he brought me some gas too. So I went ahead and put the tank and at least the pump in position right now. Just quick walk you through how it's basically the reverse of pulling it off is putting it back on. So basically you and your friend are gonna wiggle your way under here, push up. I had him tighten that one first and I wedged this over and got the nozzle aligned with this, and I put the screw in this. Well, he got that. Then I forced this one up. This one was a little bit of a struggle, but I got that one up, and then it finally mounted. And I come back up here. Instead, I grabbed the gas tank, dumped a bunch of gas in here, probably enough to get me over to the gas station, which is like, I don't know, 2 minutes away. And then I put the wall, bro, everything, put the lines back on. I put new lines. I couldn't get steel braided ones, so I ended up getting just OEM rubbers. Put those on. Put new screws down. Well, not new screws, but I cleaned them all up and degreased them and put them back. So we're at the part now where we're finishing everything up. Buckle everything up. Line her there. Get everything sealed, fire it up, see how it sounds. Be started. Yeah, I was on my lunch break from work, so I've been rushing. I've been doing most of these chops in between work, and then I sometimes work on the weekends, so I ended up doing that. No, take this one out. Is that a 10 and an 8 I need? Okay. And 10. Definitely excited and been pumped to hear this thing. Having 240 withdrawals from not driving it in like a week and a half. Definitely excited to hear it fire up. Yeah, like I said, pretty much the install is pretty much the reverse of taking it out. So I didn't feel like I needed to actually show that part. I just walked through real quick. I don't know if my friend wanted to be on camera too, so I figured I'd just put it up real quick and dump the gas real quick. That way I'm not smelling like a fuel pit up in here. Connect the connector. Also, QD clean these. Line these up. Weird mismatched hardware. This one's being a struggle. So I'm gonna put you over here. You actually won't work. So you have to go right here. Let's swap you out real quick. Oops. Damn it. I'll loosen it back up. Thank you. There. Everything's all nice and tight, connected. Okay. And I'm going to need this 8 one more time because I'm going to need to put in. Now the tab did break off on this bottom part that you guys saw in the other video, so both ends on the bottom will be zip tied. Need extension. I'll get 2 zip ties for these real quick. Make it a little easier. Definitely have a big supply of zip ties, especially with 240s. Zip tie queens. Oh, there you are. I was like, where's the other hole? This bad boy up. Zip ties, and then we put the tire on and we're good. Now after you get that, cut the zip ties. All you gotta do is remount the tires. Just need to put the tire on and get this thing off and test it. I have to move all this stuff. Tank. Okay. And these I usually torque to the spec of 85. It says anywhere between 80 and 90, I usually do in between. It'd diff me easier if I had eccentric hub rings, but previous owner didn't put them on. When he put these on, I need to get some. Lightly put these on, and then once on the ground, torque it and star pattern it. Right now, I'm just trying to get them on. It's nice and hand tight. Is good. And I just get this other little jack out of here. Now, before we start up, gotta remember to put our fuse in for the fuel pump. And it's about to get loud. Clean this off a little bit. Now, the moment of truth. Let's hear this thing primes up. Now, before that, I better torque these wheels down before I forget. There's 85. Okay. I believe 17 is what is needed for this. Nope. What is that? 34 or 3/4. Yep. With a big to small attachment. Put it back to zero. Moment of truth. Let's listen for the prime. Yep. Hey, so what's going on, guys? Last time we tried it, I actually, from sitting for so long, my battery actually completely died. So that's why it ended up killing before we could start it. We heard it prime, wouldn't start. But now I got the battery all charged up, so I'll fire it up and let you guys get a sound of that. So I'm gonna put it up in the back. Put you guys back here so you can hear it even better, the prime, and fire up and do a walk around and one last little inspection. All right, here it goes. Sounds amazing. Looks amazing. Spot on perfect. So yeah, install went good. fires up, sounds good. Yeah, it's pretty much how you drop your gas tank. You clean up the sending unit. Also, speaking of cleaning up the sending unit, I cleaned it up. I cleaned the floater. I cleaned the strip that it runs along, the magnetic strip. And right now you can't see, but I have a little short clip I'll show you of. But my fuel gauge finally reads full. The 240 world, they usually only go up to sometimes half, sometimes, you know, where it's at right now, and sometimes it doesn't read at all, so it's definitely a rare commodity to have good fuel reading. Yeah, so for our next vid, probably gonna do the battery relocation to the rear. Been wanting to do that for a while. Kind of clean up the bay a little bit. Either that or change out these door panels, these old ones. I got some new ones. I'm waiting for the material to come in to wrap it just like my floor mats. And then also I got the other seat over there. To change this one out. I'm going to paint it all nice, clean it up, steam clean it some more. Because I want a legit... I want a legit passenger seat, even though I got that bribe bucket right there that I was going to throw in on the driver's seat eventually. So I want to do that. Probably going to wrap this garnish too. I noticed it got a lot more condensation. The other two sealed up good, but then... I don't know, I kind of wanted to wrap it too, and then maybe sand and paint the, prime the doors so then I can get ready to get an actual paint job on this thing. But yeah, probably the next video would probably either be changing one of the seats, battery relocation, or cleaning up the doors and stuff like that, but... Yeah, thanks for watching. I hope that this little part 4 video series helps some people out actually cleaning, getting your tank like nice mint clean. Especially when I'm getting ready to swap out the KA for the beautiful RB. I want it to have a fresh tank to be able to drink out of. No, so yeah, pretty much it, I'd say having a 25 to 30 year old car, it's definitely a necessity to do is clean these things. So yeah, all I gotta do now is take her for a spin for a little bit. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Like I said, I'll keep making videos. More people want to see more the build instead of just seeing them all on Instagram. But also be sure to go and follow at project_sildaily at Instagram. That's probably where I mainly will post most of the stuff, more in-depth stuff like that, so get a look at how it's going. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Tune in for the next project and we'll get this going. Got a long ways to go, but I'm getting there slowly. Slowly but surely. So yeah. Thanks for watching, guys.